Hey guys, this is Captain Daniel Hyun from ABCs of Attraction, and I want to talk about my why, something that is very near and dear to my heart. I talk about Asian masculinity. What does Asian masculinity mean to me? For me, my goal in life, my purpose in life is to make each Asian brother, and yes, my Asian brother, become the best version of themselves. So let's say one day I have an Asian brother in New York or even in Florida, in Miami, and let's say one of them throws a birthday party and they invite me, and I don't know anybody, I don't know any of his friends, but he just invites me, and I go to his party and I meet all his friends, and they see, I'm like, oh, how do you know him? And all they say is just, let's say his name is Jack, and he's just Jack. And they say he's just an awesome guy and he's just his best version of himself, and just say positive things to him. And that's how I see it. I feel like right now in the media and how the US literally portrays us is emasculates us. We're these nerdy guys. Ever since, you know, Bruce Lee passed away, and it's just like, guys, we get made fun of. And here's the thing, I was that guy. I was that nerdy, chubby, fat Asian kid that everyone made fun of. And even when I lost the weight and I worked on myself, it was, hey, you're tall for an Asian guy. You're good looking for an Asian guy. You're this for an Asian guy. I'm like, are Asian men a lower standard? And it's not that I want us to be better than any other race. I don't want that. I don't want us to be better than the Caucasian guys. I don't want us to be better than the African American guys. I just want us to be considered equal. And the only way we're gonna do that is by us becoming the best version of ourselves. And that's what I support, and that's what I coach. And that is the Asian masculinity that I see. It's just each Asian man becoming the best version of themselves, right? Whoever they wanna be, but I support that. And how they do is they create the, what we call the sphere of influence. So their community of friends, their family members, their girlfriends, right? And they become the best version. It's just it's pockets of just awesome Asian guys. And in the end, you know what they'll say to us? You're awesome and you're just a cool guy. And that's what I want for all of our Asian brothers. So let me quickly talk about where my why comes from. So I remember when I was a kid, I was very fat and overweight. And until fifth grade, nobody cared that I was Asian. But once I started getting into around middle school to high school, all of a sudden race happens. It got so bad that I used to play orchestra. I used to never practice the violin because the white bullies would literally make fun of me every time they saw me with the violin. But here's the funny thing. I wanted to be part of the Caucasian bullies. I wanted to be part of their friends group because they had this higher status. They're the one who got the cheerleading white girls. They were the ones who got all the pretty girls. And at the lunch table, it's where everyone wanted to be part of. So I was willing to let them make fun of me. And I remember this one time we went on right before Halloween night, it's called Mischief Night. It's where you TP other people's houses. And there was this one Asian guy, and I'm gonna open up to you, this still hurts me when I talk about it, is we went to this one Asian guy who was on the bus, who was straight from China. He didn't know how to speak any English, and he wore like these Asian cartoon anime shirts and pants all the time, and he would get made fun of, and I never stood up for him. But it's not even that. The worst part is I, with the other white bullies, even while I was getting made fun of the whole time, I TP'd that Asian boy's house, and you know what happened? His father came out, and he was yelling at us as we ran away. And I remember at that moment, that represented my father and how my father and my mom has been harassed. And I remember one kid literally said, fuck you, Asians, go back to your country, and opened the door and like threw something near my mom. And I remember I told my mom, I'm gonna kill these guys. And that is one of the reasons why I realized I need to work on myself and become the best version of myself. And that's why through high school, I applied for the Air Force Academy. And the Air Force Academy was my way of growing up and becoming more of a masculine male, but also the best version of myself. It taught me discipline, it taught me structure, it taught me to work out and get, you know, in better shape. Each Asian man has a superhero inside him. He has the best version of him inside him. And I realized if I could do this, and I'm working on myself every day to become the best version of myself, I want my fellow brothers to continue this journey, because that's the only way we're gonna create this positive image for Asian men. We're the only race where women literally date 60% to 70% outside their race. And all this stuff, It's we're the swipe the least on Tinder. BuzzFeed literally did an article on this on Cosmopolitan magazine. They said that Asian or gay, this gets to stop, because I want to be at least a voice, at least one voice, saying that it's time for us to step up and become the best man we can be. And to me, that is where my why comes from. So here's my call to action for you, my Asian brothers. Okay, just like I made myself better. I forced myself to go into a place where it's so uncomfortable, aka boot camp, right? I had to wake up at 5 a.m. every single morning. I had to do push-ups, and I literally went through hell for 1 year. I challenge you to go and become uncomfortable and really challenge yourself to become the best man you can be, either with it through working with us or putting yourself out there, putting yourself out of your comfort zone. I challenge you to become the best version of yourself by facing your fears. So if you ever want to reach out to me and you want to share your personal story and your personal why, please message me on Facebook, which the account is down below, and also my Instagram, which is just Captain Daniel Hyun. And please subscribe. This is how we pass on the message.
Thanks for watching our video. I hope you liked it. And make sure you guys subscribe to this channel and watch all our other videos. Great news too. Every Monday, we'll be putting out a new weekly video. That's right, we've got educational seminars, street interviews, fun infield pickup videos, and anything else we can come up with that's fun for you guys to watch. So check back.